So now we'd like to begin our first session with Mr. William Tanuwijaya, co-founder of Tokopedia. And today he's going to share his story of how he built Tokopedia, which is an Indonesian number one e-commerce platform, despite being faced with lots of difficulties along the way. So we believe that his story is insightful and will hopefully push more young people into innovation. So let's give him a nice warm welcome. Let's welcome William.
Thank you. So good afternoon, everyone. My name is William Tanuwijaya. I'm a founder and CEO of Tokopedia, an online marketplace from Indonesia. It's truly an honor for me to be here today amongst founder, entrepreneurs, investors, media, people of Osaka, and people of the world. Osaka, I'm very happy to be in Osaka because Osaka is a very special place in my life. Later on, I will share the story about why it's so special for me. Today, I will share about my entrepreneurial journey. I consider myself as an entrepreneur by necessity, entrepreneur by accident. I will tell a story about how internet truly changed my life. I was born and grew in a small hometown in North Sumatra Island, Pematang Siantar. I spent all my childhood there. And when I graduated from high school, my parents, my late father and my uncle want me to have a better chance of life. And for them, a better chance of life start from a better education. So they give me a chance to go outside of my hometown in 1999. In 1999, to a boat, 4 days and three nights, I finally arrived in Jakarta, the capital city of Indonesia. I studied computer science in local university. On semester two, my late father started getting sick. So in order to stay in Jakarta, I tried to find a job. And at that time, around my university, there's a many internet cafe. Because internet at that time is still a luxury. And that's my first job. I start working 9 p.m. to 9 a.m. every day as an internet cafe operator at the Jombi Steve. But that's truly become a blessing in disguise because for the next 3 years during my college time, I have access to internet for free, actually getting paid for that. And that's how I fall in love with internet. In 2003, when I graduated from the college, I always want to work for internet company. But the internet company that I admire, like Google, Facebook, has not have a representative office at that time in Indonesia. So I just worked as a software engineer or web designer in a couple of company. There's no really a tech startup boom at that time. So usually it's just a B2B system, a corporate system, and so on. And in 2007, finally, I got an idea to start my own journey building a tech company, internet company, Tokopedia. Because in 2007, I identified that Indonesia is the largest archipelago country in the world with 17,000 islands. So there's lots of cases when one stranger from another island want to buy or sell product to another stranger in another island that cannot meet, do not know each other. But there's no way to do online transactions safely. So there's no trust in online. And I studied around and I find out how eBay with PayPal in US and how Alibaba with Taobao, Alipay in China solve this issue. And I want to start it one in 2007. I know that I can build a marketplace, but I didn't have any capital at that time. And my late father at that time got cancer, and I'm the only worker in my family, so I do not even have a luxury to start this as a garage project. Inspired by a young entrepreneur from US, a founder of Google, a founder of Facebook, when I read their story, they start building the tech company during a university time. I know perhaps they also don't have a capital to start their business. So how they can do that? And I learned about there's a venture capital, people are raising money in Silicon Valley and so on. I want to try the same model in Indonesia, but at that time I didn't know any venture capital. So in 2007, I went to the only person that I know have money, which is the boss of my company. In 2007, I worked for this company that providing a tax services business. So the service works like this. If you are, this is emerging market, Indonesia. Says if you are a fan of Manchester United, you can subscribe information about Manchester United through SMS text services. So every day you'll get the short message about the information, the latest information about your favorite football club. I come to him in 2007, to my boss, and pitch about this idea, about the marketplace. I tell him that I work for you for 2 years already, since 2005, but there's no single time when I use the services of this company. Why? Because I'm already internet users. So if I want to get any information about my favorite football club, whatever it is, I can just go to the internet and pull that information. So there's a lifetime about this business and it will be replaced by internet. And there's a demand in the market. That marketplace will solve this issue, this problem about trust in the market. My boss at that time was kind enough, so he introduced me to a lot of his friends, a local REITs. Took me 2 years, 2007, 2008, 2009, to keep pitching about the idea of building the first working marketplace in Indonesia, Tokopedia. But no one want to support it. No one want to invest. No one want to back the idea. If I summarize the reasons why I fail, people will keep asking me about 5 questions. The first questions people will ask is about, William, can you tell me one person in Indonesia that being wealthy, rich, success because of doing technology or internet business? And unfortunately, during that time, 2007, 2008, 2009, I cannot name one. There's no Mark Zuckerberg of Indonesia, there's no Jack Ma of Indonesia, there's no Miki Tanisan of Indonesia. So when I cannot name one, the potential investors cannot see how they can get their money back. So there's no exit for them. There's no track record of the industry. The second question will be, William, Indonesia is a huge market, 250 million population, 4th largest populations in the world. If you prove to the world that the Indonesia need marketplace, and you are not reinventing the wheel, you just want to beat eBay of Indonesia, Alibaba of Indonesia, and this is already 2007 or 2008 or 2009, where eBay started in 1996, Alibaba started in early 2000s. It's only about time they will come to Indonesia. And when they come to Indonesia, how can you compete with them? I don't know how to answer that question at that time. And because of that second question, people will always ask about my background, which family that I come from. In Indonesia, usually there's a family business and so on, but unfortunately I come from a very humble family. And even though I am the only worker in my family at that time, so I cannot convince anyone if things go wrong. The fourth question will be, which university that you graduated from? If you come back from, say, Ivy League, Harvard, MIT, Stanford, perhaps you have a better chance to compete when all the giants comes to Indonesia. But no, to be honest, I consider myself graduated from internet cafe because I spend my college time in internet cafe. And the last questions people will always ask about, what is your previous background? Have you ever started building a business before? Do you have any business background? No. I just become a worker the whole of my life. So there's no track record about myself. There's no track record of industry. That makes it almost impossible at the time to convince people to put even seed funding to the idea to start Tokopedia. One thing that changed my life is when I met with this potential investor, that he gave me this one piece of advice. William, you are still young, and unfortunately, you can only young once. You can only have your youth one time in life. So don't waste your time. Find something more realistic to do. Don't dream too high. You bring all this glory story of Silicon Valley, the story of Google and Facebook. The founders are born special, and unfortunately, you are not. That's become a wake-up call for me. And that's the moment where I identify that starting business in Indonesia is extremely challenging, because starting business in emerging market, or perhaps in any place in the world, is about credibility, it's about trust, and credibility is about your track record. But that's about Tokopedia. The inception of the idea is because we want to solve the trust issue. I always consider the story of Tokopedia, our journey, as a story of an underdog. And for me, as an underdog, you need to have at least three things. The first thing will be the courage. So we are very lucky, even though we are underdog, no, we are very lucky at that time we have a courage to believe in ourselves when no one believes in us. To have a courage to never give up, to take that rejection as a mission of life. So that moment is when I decided Tokopedia should be the mission of my life, that I should not give up at any cost. Because if it took many years for us to start Tokopedia, when Tokopedia become a public service that Indonesian people can use, we are actually help everyone in Indonesia that want to start or expand their business online, they can start it instantly. But of course, courage will not bring you anywhere. That's why as an underdog, you need to have a perseverance. And the story is all about perseverance. It took us finally 2 years to raise the first seed funding round, and we can start the company in early 2009. And then on 2010, there's a big things happen in Indonesia. Yahoo, at that time, acquired local SNS platform, Kopro. And that's become all eyes start to go to Indonesia. Couple of VCs comes to Indonesia. So finally, I have a chance to meet with the real venture capital that understand internet business. Come from US and the rest of the world. But I failed, because I failed to communicate. Because until I didn't speak English until 2010. I can read English, I can understand English, but I cannot communicate that properly. But I'm very lucky because I met with a couple of Japanese investors that also speak broken English. So they have more patience to understand what I'm trying to with. So all our early investors, East Ventures, Cyber Agent, NetPrice, Binos, Binex, that's all Japanese investors that become a close friend for me until today. They helped me become my buddy to learn about English. to take me start going overseas to see the world. So it's about perseverance, even though you fail to communicate. You don't give up. You try your best until you can communicate. The first things that we did when we started the company is goes back to my university. Because starting a technology company, your company is only as good as your product. And your product is only as good as your people. So invest on the people is the most important things to do. 2 days I spent time in my university standing there trying to convince people to join the company, and no one applied. In front of us is a booth of the one of the biggest bank in Indonesia. They didn't have a founder or the CEO of the company standing there. They only have a sales promotion girl. But it's a very crowded and people making a line to apply to that bank. So that's another reality check for me. And that's a moment where I know that I need to step out of my comfort zone, that I need to tell the mission of Tokopedia repeatedly to convince people to join the company. I have a lot of imaginary mentors. Just reading on internet, one of them is Steve Jobs. Steve Jobs used to say that A people need to hire A people. Because if once A people hire B people will hire C people will hire D people, and so on until you have a Z people. I'm very frustrated at that time. Because what the hell is Steve Jobs trying to say? On my case, I cannot even convince a C people or D people to join my company, right? So what we did at that time is, we know that we need to tell the vision and the mission of the company. But I'm unfortunately a very introvert person, a very shy person, and public speaking is the biggest fear that I cannot know how to tackle it, even until today. The experience about you're waiting, your hand will be cold, your heart will skip a bit when the announcer call your name. You have many eyes. It's like a pressure, a constant pressure. I never enjoy that. I don't know if I can do that. But whenever there's a small university in Indonesia ask me to share my experience, I always take that opportunity to tell about what we want to build. And over time, even though the first year we only have 4 people joining the company, today, per month, we can have up to 24,000 candidates applying to our company, even though we only have 20 openings. And today we only employ 400 people in Tokopedia. So it's all about perseverance, stepping out of your comfort zone, doing things that you are not like to do, and keep growing and growing as a person. So that's all about the perseverance. At first, when we are small, we want to work together with the big bank, big corporate, big logistic company. No one wants to work with us because we are too small. But we keep knocking the doors until the doors open. That's perseverance. And the last things that the underdog need to have, at least, is hope. The reasons why Tokopedia can be Tokopedia until today is because we have that courage, we have that perseverance, and we have that hope. Internet truly changed my life. Even though we need 2 years to convince the first investor to invest, in October 2014, Tokopedia became one of the first Southeast Asia company that get trust, that get invest funding from both SoftBank and Sequoia Capital with a $100 million round investment. And I want to tell a story about that. And this is why Osaka is so special for me. So in 29 September 2014, I got a call from SoftBank. They asked me if I can flew to Japan to meet with Son-san. on early October, 3rd October 2014. But as an Indonesian, I need visa. And to apply for visa, I need at least 4 working days. So I consider myself very lucky. Sometimes you need a lot of serendipity moment in life. And I'm very lucky because at that time, I already got a visa. Why? Because at that time, I've been in a long-term relationship with my girlfriend, 7 years, date for 7 years. She studied medicine, I start building Tokopedia. And at that time, she graduated, become a doctor, and she said to me, William, we both work so hard. Let's have a break. Let's go to Japan. She always fond of Japan. By the time I say to her that I cannot, Tokopedia is need to grow and so on, I cannot leave Tokopedia. But secretly, I actually plan to chase her to this holiday trip in Japan to propose to her in Osaka. So that's why, for the first time, I go to my HR, file for a leave, apply for a visa, having a ticket, everything's done. And how serendipity it is. When 29 September 2014, I get that phone call. And of course, I can say, yes, I will be in Japan already. So 30 September 2014, my good friends, mentors, Sato-san from Binos asked me to meet with Sequoia Capital partner, Sailendra. He's in town, in Jakarta. I met with him for 1 hour, 2 p.m. to 3 p.m. that day. And by evening, I'm leaving Jakarta to Osaka. On the car, I got a phone call, which has come from Sequoia Capital. And they say that, William, can you meet with me, with us tomorrow? On 1st October, I say that, I'm sorry, I'm on the way to Osaka. And on my surprise, on 1st October 2014, when I landed in Osaka, the venture's partner of Sequoia Capital is already in Osaka. So we spent until 5 p.m. This is the first time I go to Osaka. It's supposed to be a proposal trip. It's a strange town for me. Until 5 p.m., I still have this conversation, and I keep seeing my words. I don't know where's my girlfriend. I don't know where to buy the flower, and so on and so on. So I need to terminate, dismiss the meetings. And on that evening, I proposed to my now wife in Umeda Sky Building. So that's why Osaka is very special for me. Thank you. 2nd October, I fly to Tokyo. 3rd October, I met with Son-san. And then this is the week where serendipity happens, a week of 3 proposals. So I get 2 proposals, I propose one. And very, very lucky that everyone say yes. So that's how internet changed my life. And that's not only changed my life. With internet, with Tokopedia, we are changing at least directly to 500,000, a half million of people, ordinary people, that start and grew their business in Tokopedia. And there's a couple, there's a 4 of that story about how internet can change ordinary people's life.
Dulu saya bekerja serabutan. Dimulai saya SMP dan sampai saya lulus SMA itu sebetulnya saya seorang pengamen jalanan.
Dulunya saya itu adalah asisten dokter gigi. Saya bekerja sebagai asisten dokter gigi itu kurang lebih selama 4 tahun.
Sekitar tahun 2013, perusahaan mengadakan program PHK di mana saya dikasih 2 pilihan untuk bisa tetap stay di perusahaan tersebut ataupun boleh mengambil program PHK-nya. Saya memilih untuk keluar.
Dulu sebelum mengenal internet, saya pikir cara memperoleh penghasilan hidup hanya dengan pekerjaan-pekerjaan ideal yang banyak dilakukan orang. Saya menjadi karyawan di salah satu perusahaan swasta di kota saya. Sampai akhirnya saya berpikir, hidup saya tidak ada perubahan hanya dengan ini.
Saya mulai bangkit karena pada saat itu saudara saya membawakan buku tentang bagaimana cara membuat pernak-pernik dari tepung terigu. Nah, saya coba pelajari sedikit demi sedikit dengan otodidak. Alhamdulillah, selama satu bulan saya coba, ternyata hasilnya lumayan. Nah, disitulah saya melihat dan berpikir ini ada peluang bisnisnya. Alhamdulillah, sampai sekarang 2015, kami sudah banyak melatih sampai ribuan orang dan banyak masyarakat yang terbantu, terlihat perubahannya. Jadi banyak teman-teman yang sekarang ini tadinya dia seorang pengamen juga, yang tadinya dia seorang pemulung juga, terbantu secara perekonomiannya.
Suami saya punya bisnis kerajinan monel, tapi untuk pemasarannya itu hanya sebatas offline aja. Terus aku berpikir kenapa nggak dibuat secara online aja. Kalau secara online kan kita bisa memasarkan ke seluruh penjuru Nusantara.
Oh, Bali Biwit Bagus, awalnya dikelola oleh anak saya Audrey. Saat itu dia masih kelas 1 SMP. Kebetulan dia memang suka tanaman dan dia sangat interest untuk belajar wirausaha bisnis online.
Selama saya berjualan di Tokopedia, banyak pencapaian-pencapaian yang sudah saya dapatkan, terutama untuk anak saya Audrey. Dia lebih semangat untuk berwirausaha karena apa? Dari hasil itu dia bisa membeli sesuatu yang dia inginkan. Di samping itu, dengan dia berjualan di Bit, memberi keinginan dia seperti cita-citanya untuk melanjutkan khusus ke pertanian.
Saya berusaha mencari peluang usaha lain yang bisa saya jadikan sebagai sumber pendapatan. Sampai tanpa sengaja adik ipar saya datang membawa wall sticker. Saya masih ingat, dulu orang lingkungan sekitar saya banyak sekali yang meragukan bisnis ini. Tapi sekarang saya buktikan, saya bisa sukses di sini. Sekarang dengan toko online saya ini, dari segala penderitaan yang pernah saya alami dulu, keputusan saya untuk keluar dari perusahaan, sekarang membuahkan hasil. Dan saya senang. Apa yang saya dapatkan sekarang jauh lebih bagus daripada apa yang saya peroleh dulu.
Saya percaya selama saya melakukan kegiatan ini, saya dapat banyak sekali membantu orang-orang. Dan saya percaya untuk berbisnis, kita tidak harus mengejar selalu materi. Dimana kalau kita mengejar ilmu dan kita selalu membantu banyak orang, rezeki itu pun akan menghampiri kita, karena Allah selalu akan membantu orang-orang yang banyak membantu orang lainnya.
Kalau kita mau berwirausaha, sebenarnya banyak hal yang bisa kita lakukan dan tidaklah sulit. Selama ada internet, kita mau berinovasi, pasti bisa dilakukan.
Daripada kita buka tutup toko, lebih baik kita buka tutup laptop. Dengan begitu, kita bisa memasarkan produk-produk kita ke seluruh penjuru Nusantara.
Jadi percayalah, internet memberikan peluang usaha sebesar-besarnya kepada kita, asal kita mau belajar mengelolanya dengan baik.
So turn out of the 6 year, Tokopedia grew together with the dream of the small business in Indonesia. And it's become a platform of startup, because startup is not only a technology startup. Anyone that wants to start their business is another startup. It's become a platform to start, it's become a platform of opportunity. And it's become a motivation and inspiration for us every day to do our best, because it's a people dreams. We believe that marketplace business, you can only succeed if you help other people to become more successful. And for me, this is the most beautiful business model in the world. On the early days, when that potential investors were asking me about how you can compete when all the giants comes to Indonesia, that happens. 6 months after we launched Tokopedia, eBay, the leading C2C marketplace from US, come to Indonesia joint venture with the leading telecommunication company, Telkom. Second year, Rakuten, the leading marketplace from Japan, enters Indonesia market with a partnership with largest media conglomerate in Indonesia, MNC. The third year, Multiply, a social network platform from US, get acquired by Naspers, MIH, and move the headquarters from California to Jakarta with the goal to become marketplace of Southeast Asia. Fourth year, Rocket Internet, and so on and so on. Every single year, there's a bigger competition come. And they already have the technology. They already have the know-how. And the local partner is the media conglomerate or telco conglomerate that already have the distribution channel. On the paper, there's no single chance we can even survive. But today I can answer that because I sincerely think that we, the one that live in internet era, is the luckiest generation ever. Because in internet era, everyone has a chance. Even underdog has a chance. As long as they have a courage to challenge the status quo, have a perseverance to against all the odds, and maintain hope to survive long enough and eventually become the winner. And this is not only about Tokopedia. If we see all successful internet company in the world, Google, for example, when they started, they are the underdog. There's already Yahoo, Hasta La Vista, the status quo of search engine. But today, they are the winner. Facebook, also not the first or the status quo of social media on the early days. They are the challenger of status quo, but today they made it happen. That's the beauty of internet. On the early days, I also get that advice about not dreaming high to find something realistic to do. But I always remind it by a quote from the founding father of Indonesia, the first president of Indonesia, Insinyur Soekarno. He used to say to the people of Indonesia to dream as high as the sky. If you fall, you will fall amongst the stars. And for me, that's very beautiful. And I also reminded by the quote of Martin Luther King Jr. He used to say that there's a two type of dreamer. One is a dreamer that dreams with their eyes closed, and the second is the dreamer that dreams with their eyes open. And the one that dreams with their eyes open is the visioner. So for me, dream as high as the sky is about dream with your eyes open. And we are lucky in Tokopedia, we have that opportunity, that journey to dream with our eyes open. For us, dreaming with eyes open is as simple as what you dream, what you think, what you speak, and what you do is always consistent and in sync. If we can do that long enough, we believe that there's no dream that too high to achieve. So as a closer, there's many founders in this room. Remember that we start from an underdog. So what happens in the future, whatever how big we are, I think it's very important to have a humility, to remain humble, because we need to maintain that underdog in our heart. So I'm William Tanuwijaya. I hope that you enjoy the story. Thank you so much. Arigato gozaimasu.
Thank you, William, for sharing your personal story with us. A very inspirational speech, I'm sure you'll agree. So let's give him one more warm round of applause. Fantastic. Thank you.